Finite and Infinite Games is a dance film which is a collaboration among artist, meaning painter, filmmaker, costume designer, and choreographer. And we molded all of those people to create this dance film. The title is based off of a philosophical text by James P. Carse. And it talks about the games in life being finite or infinite. For example, tic-tac-toe would be an infinite game because in some aspects, the X's and the O's, you never win. It's finite once you win. Kate took the games aspect of this text and incorporated it into dance. We actually have a piece called Tic-Tac-Toe, which has a mandala of the tic-tac-toe board on the floor. And the piece proceeds so that certain dancers are dancing into the blocks, and once three are in a row, they dance off together as winners, and the rest dance off as losers. There are three main characters, myself, Ari, who plays the man character, and Meg. And they're taking part in this process called life. Everyone else is the community. Ari is having a difficult time getting associated with the community, and he finds me something that he needs to attach himself to, so we go through this dueling process because I don't want to be controlled. And eventually, in the finale, you see that this infinity movement is happening, which the community draws us all into one at a time, and finally, he's the last one to really accept being in this community. During the shoot week, James P. Carse lives in the area near Judson and actually dropped by the film shoot to see. I mean, he never expected it to be taken artistically. The venue was awesome. It was at Judson Memorial Church, which is a historical landmark for dance. A lot of dancers and choreographers who are really big names or have become big names got their start there. Twyla Tharp, Merce Cunningham. So it was really an honor to have this film take place there.